In this video, we will cover configuring the seed tube sensors with a seed tube monitor module on an InCommand 1200 display. Before planting with the seed tube monitor module, a sensor configuration is required to detect seed for population and advanced seed monitoring. From the home screen, tap the wrench. Before configuring the seed tube monitoring module, you must first have your planting configurations built. For this example, we will show the setup process for a split planter that can plant at either 16 or 31 rows. Tap on either configuration, then tap the wrench. Next, tap seed monitor. From this screen, we will want to enter the number of split and standard rows the planter is capable of. For standard planters, the split row selection must remain at 0. Next, set the speed source for the module. If a GPS receiver is being utilized for the display, select GPS. Now tap sensor configuration. Select split row from the drop-down to configure first. This selection screen will not be shown for standard row planters. Tap the green check. In the sensor configuration screen, tap Auto Config. This matches a pin on the module to the row it will be sensing and displaying on the InCommand Run screen. Since we are configuring the split row first, be sure to enter the correct row spacing. Also, from this screen, we can highlight a row and then tap Status to disable a sensor if one should fail during planting. Always remember to enable a sensor after a failed one has been replaced. In the event a non-Ag Leader cable is being used or a repair is made to a harness that resulted in mismatched pins, the calculator icon can be used to enter a custom value to match up a pin on the module to a corresponding seed tube sensor. With the split row autoconfig complete, tap the green check. Next, we must return to sensor configuration. And now select standard row for the configuring process. Tap the green check. Tap autoconfig. Verify row spacing is correct, then tap the green check. To edit any low or high thresholds for population, tap Alarms. Then select the row type you wish to edit. Tap on a row or tap Select All if you would like to change the values for all rows. Use the remaining high and low buttons to edit or disable alarms. Tap the green check when finished. With all values set to match our planter and the autoconfig process complete, tap the green check to exit the seed monitor screen. The configuration process for the seed tube monitor module is now complete. Now you will be able to perform a sensor configuration for your seed tube monitor module for proper population and advanced seed monitoring. If you would like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.